that good stuff, man. Happy New Year's, man. Then a little quick morning spell. You know, sort of a New Year's introduction. And a last year cap out, man. We're gonna run it down, man. We're gonna get to it, man. You know what I mean? It's that time. You know, I ain't having no plans, really, of going to where I'm about to go this year. This year, I do it'll be a much better year, you know. Different situation, more loyal and stable people what I thought was my friends, stuff like that or whatever, man, you know. I get it now, you know what I mean? I get it. It's clearly all the way through, man, you know. Took a little reflection, a little time to sit back and properly calculate and think out, you know, exactly what it is taking place, man. You know, and it's a sickness, man. It's a sickness going on, man. It's just too bad that, you know, people are so far and stuck up in it that it don't really matter whether it's a sickness or not. They don't care, you know? It's a drug to them. Anyway, it's crazy when a person can tell you, I was loyal to you, this and that. I mean, you was loyal, nigga. Why the fuck you on the internet screaming and yelling like a motherfucking, you know what I mean? A zoo pack, a circus clown. You know what I mean? That ain't loyalty, man. You know what I mean? Loyal niggas do what loyal niggas do, man. You know what I'm saying? Bottom line. You know what I mean? Just being 100 with y'all. Like I said, this is entitled The Realest Shit I Ever Spoke. For a reason, man. Shit about to get highly real in here. You know what I mean? You know, I'm the same dude, you know, when niggas are sleeping on their aunt couch and all that and getting thrown out by their aunts and all that. You know, I had no other alternative. They was able to come from over Jersey and come over here and hang out with a real nigga. Get they mind right. Get they sip on. You know what I mean? Get to meet new niggas, new people. Different situation, man. You know what I mean? Different category, different conversation. But a lot of that shit go over a motherfucker head. You know, every nigga that ever claimed they was loyal to me, cause I said no one time. You know? Took to the end there screaming and yelling. Keep in mind, we only a phone call or maybe 15 minutes to 30 minutes apart, and we could have pulled up, you know what I mean, and got to our issue if it was an issue. You know what I'm saying? But instead, a nigga rather take the jealous route, call the nigga name in vain, you know, talk about what a nigga ever did or didn't do. First of all, let's be 100. Just being 100. Right? Who the fuck with no stats 280? If he wasn't screaming hybrid. And so he's not Lori the Nitro, because if he was, he wouldn't have took off. So if you loyal to a motherfucker, let me tell you what you don't do. You don't take off on a situation until conversations have been had. Until you truly respect what the next person have to say, their intentions, how they feel about the situation. You know what I mean? I made niggas, man. I made people know people, man. Until then, niggas is motherfucking closet rats. You know what I mean? Nobody ever heard of you. You behind a motherfucking computer screen, jacking a nigga swag, want to emulate and imitate everything you see me doing. You know what I mean? Until another nigga bring a nigga on board, cause they feel their story or feel their pain. I ain't feel your pain cause I ain't know you, nigga. You know what I mean? And the sad part about it is once I got to know you, you know what I mean? I thought you was a pretty cool dude, so I extended my hand. You know? Let's get to the part of CK not doing nothing for motherfuckers. How you get them songs mixed and mastered? Who paid for that studio time? Who paid for all that gourmet food in the studio? Who paid for all the gallons of Hennessy? You ain't paid for it. Shy 120 ain't paid for it. Who paid for all that? Every time my nigga Jugs mix a song down, it's $65 per song. I'm getting multiple songs. Every time we call, we in there for an hour or two. I buy 10-hour blocks. Who paid for all that? You can ask Chris Gotti. Even though I'm a member of Adventures Music, and I'm a signed artist under Adventures Music, Nitro got signed. I got Nitro signed. So Nitro's not going to see or feel what the next nigga feel, because he know what it is. He know how hard I work. He's in talk to legal. You know what legal mean? That's the attorney behind Hybrid Entertainment. Not the attorney, the attorneys, paralegals, lawyers, so on and so forth. Who paid for that? Who paid for them? Who paid for that, you know, the representation? You know what I mean? Who paid for consultation? Man, I never did nothing. I asked a nigga for his government name, and automatically the nigga take to the internet saying somebody trying to play him, niggas trying to find dirt in him. Hey, stupid motherfucking moron, pay attention. You cannot drop an album on any platform. And anybody else out there is watching, that's for me with the music industry, you cannot drop an album or anything without signing a W-9 form. Ask anybody in the industry, ask Steve Stout, ask Nas, ask Jay-Z, ask Puffy. How do you get paid? If I drop an LP right now, and let's just say we got 300 on the album, right? They can't pay 300. They don't know who 300 is. Who is 300? What's his social security? What's his name? First and last name? What's his address? What's his cell phone number? How do you get paid royalty? Let's just deal with that first. We're going to deal with the business side first. You understand? 20 as well, man. That's where the problem is at. You keep saying I'm your twin, so you bring me down to your level. You're not my twin, bro. Because my twin would have had more understanding of the situation, not get in my personal business, tell people you don't like and respect how they being treated, so on and so forth. That's not what twins do. What twins do is, yo, my nigga, trust me, everything gonna work itself out. This is what CK do. When CK get quiet, CK not on one, but he's on one, meaning he's trying to make sure the team eat. You heard him, you heard Shy said it in the song. Why CK sit back and devise a plan for us to make us some millions. I'm always thinking about the team, not me. If that's the case, I would have been signed, and that was it. I got a deal thrown at me for Nitro, and Nitro took care of all the terms and agreements according to what he wanted in his deal. I didn't negotiate that for him. I just got him to set up. I got him to meet, and I got him to set up. And Nitro deal is based on what he wanted as an artist, what he wanted as a boss. That's why I call him Young CEO. So yeah, 2022, I'm revealing it. Nitro has a deal. He's already has a situation. All right? And in all reality, I feel like Stash 280, Shy 120, and a few other dudes became jealous, feeling like I was putting all my energies into Nitro. I tell y'all what, make better music. Simply put. It's just that simple. Make better music. Oh, CK this and that. Oh, CK, he be bragging. And so that motherfucker, everything I wear on my back, every car I drive, every pair of shoes I put on my feet, every piece of food I put in me and my children, because I have kids, and my kids' mouth. I earn that, my nigga. Nobody's giving me nothing. I got homeboys out here right now that's multi-millionaire. And live in big homes in Atlanta and in Hamptons and shit like that. They gonna tell you, that nigga ain't never asked for a dime. You know what I'm saying? I get up and I get it how I get it. So when you see me, you know what I mean? So when you see me counting bread with all these unappreciative niggas that can give me what I gave them back in one hand, which is a lie. I remember niggas, yo, CK, let me get blah, blah, blah. When I get my check, I'll give it back. And on multiple weeks, I gave it to him. You know why? Because it's not always about me. It's not always about me. You know what I mean? It's not always about me, bro. And I've put myself out there time and time again, even to the point where I have the women in my life send these niggas money. But they forget about that. When a nigga extending his hand and trying to motherfucking be a brother and, you know, not an enabler. So yeah, sometimes I produce, other times I fall back to liberty, cause I don't want to enable anybody. But that goes over people's head. I'm being selfish. It's always about me. Oh yeah, you having a CK moment. I don't have moments, my nigga. I don't have moments. This is my life. This is my life. This is how I move. This is the air I breathe. I'm not breathing. I'm breathing CK air. It's my oxygen. Now, if you can't breathe, I blow breath in your lung. You know what I mean? Facts, homie. Facts, right? But at the end of the day, every conversation a nigga ever had, I said, niggas told me. I just chose not to respond to it. When niggas question every nigga's integrity, that's my bro, homie. We can't even have a conversation about that. I'm talking about Shaw 120 right now. Every time a nigga brought that man in, but been vain, I said, yo, stop, bro. That's my bro. We're not doing it. To this day, I'm mad at him right now. I'm mad at him. That's my brother. I'm going to do what I do with him. Stash 2A in the other hand, he's the outsider, bro. I embraced that man, not knowing him from a hole in Adam. Nitro brought him. Nitro brought him to the table. Before, you see them on 212 with CK Corey King, before he was screaming hybrid, I want you to answer the question. By the way, I see the donation. Thanks for the donation. Who knew this man? You know they're not calling him out his name anyway. He keeps telling, oh, CK this and that. Nigga, I'm across the bridge, my nigga. Pull up. That's that. We ain't gonna talk about it. Pull up. I be your hucky butt, nigga. Pull up. You know what I mean? But at the end of the day, my thing is, who knew this nigga before he came amongst me, Shooter Low, Nitro, Shy 120, Miss Brim? These are the original members right here. And those members go as so. Me, Shy 120, Shooter Low, Big Drippy, and Miss Brim. And then it started branching out. Nitro active. And up until niggas became disgruntled, yo, we was one big happy family. But niggas have a tendency of breaking shit up. You know what I mean? Let's be real. You know what I mean? Disgruntledness, black people. Never satisfied, never happy. So we sit back. I mean, I see your comments, Sha. You know what I mean? You ain't innocent, nigga. You ain't innocent, nigga. And if I was you, I just took this verbal lesson and let it go, man. That's it. Breathe a little bit, my nigga. Yeah, you see the face. Remember that face from way back? Yeah, that nigga back. You pulled that nigga back out. So any call outs, any day, nigga, let it be known, my nigga. I pull up, my nigga. Dirty dancing. Hey, once I pull up, I don't want to talk. Dirty dancing. That's it. On my flag, dirty dancing for anybody. I got that for anybody that want it. So at the end of the day or whatever, my thing is this right here, right? Continuously I ask the question, all right, but what did I do wrong? You already know, salute, beloved. What did I do wrong? Even with Sha was doing X, Y, Z, he was making this music. I can't take that from him. Niggas knew who Sha 120 was. I just added on to his popularity. But he had his own brand. Shaka said, yeah, blah, blah, blah. And niggas said, yeah, he was fucking with Click Clack. I've been in circles where niggas said, yo, you're the kid Shy 120, yeah, he with Click Clack. He had his own name. You see how real I keep it? I'm not online calling him a dick sucker. This, I'm mad. It's my brother, but I'm mad at him right now. Why? Because he continued to talk to a nigga who continued to lie on me. I sent Shy a text where the nigga told Nitro, yeah, Shy 120 says CK is lying. I don't see you addressing that, Shy. So in my eyes, it must be an act of guilt because the Shy 120 I know that took off on Bullets Gotti and everybody else would have took off on this nigga. Get the fuck, nigga, like, because one day everybody in the world know that be around me, CK do not start trouble. CK is not in people's business. CK don't ask for nothing. CK don't lie on people. Come on, bro. I sent you to black and white instead of you saying, yo, what? And dealing with him, you keep trying to argue back and forth and give me lip service. Nigga, I'm innocent in this. I got nothing to do with that. I did one act that every nigga on this chat's supposed to do. When niggas' names start coming in question, when niggas' names, you see what Uptown said? Facts. When niggas' names start coming in question, you get them niggas on the phone. That's what I did. Only thing I did. I seen the clickbait. CK tried to expose Wahlberg and Ever Buzz. That wasn't true as clickbait. What I did was, I didn't want the team online arguing with each other. So I called Shot 120. I called Shot 120 phone, because Wahlberg called me talking about Shot. Whoa, stop. We cannot have this conversation with that Shot being present. Hold on, bro. I called Shot. Am I lying, Shot? Because he ain't here riffing with me, but am I lying, you nigga? I calls him, boom. They start talking. Stat's name come up. What? Stop right there, y'all. Don't disrespect. Stat's name came up. Get Stat's on the phone. He can't defend himself, not knowing what's going on. I got Stat's on the phone. Lamonte Sims, I don't know this nigga either. He don't answer his phone. So when Wahlberg Brim and Shot talking, the energy changes, they talking like men. Stat's the first nigga who leave. Whoop, out the conversation. I guess he didn't want to hear it. He leaves. I'm the second nigga. Whoop, I leave. Because if y'all talking like men, there's no need for me to referee your grown men. You're on the phone now. Nobody's backbiting. CK off. And I promise you, I tell y'all, I forgot about the whole conversation. Weeks didn't went by. Know what I mean? I forgot about the situation. I'm done. I'm out of there. Niggas want to kick Wahlberg off of Eastern District. Yeah, it was my brainchild, but Wahlberg is one of the founders of Eastern District. This is shit that apparently Stats and Lamonte don't know or whatever, but he helped me start it. Him, Pink Sugar, and my man motherfucker Reek the Sneak, CEO Reek. They helped me start Eastern District, right? The politics start happening. Niggas is motherfucking kicking Reek out of their ass, so on and so forth. As an admin, I bring him back in as an admin. Why? This is why I don't do. I don't take niggas' side just because we cool. You can be a total stranger. I'm going to give you a fair shake. Why? I'm going to give you what I want for myself. This is what I'm doing. I'm explaining to y'all why niggas is mad. Niggas ain't mad because I did nothing. I didn't sit behind nobody back. None of that. Niggas is mad because I didn't kick Wahlberg. The East Side Blood now, the Hat Boy, I didn't kick the Hat Boy off of Eastern District. So because of that, they said I chose a side. No, nigga. If I would have chosen a side, I would have kicked y'all. I didn't kick stats to them out of there until I came in one of their rooms to support. They had a chat going, a Q&A, and they had it where I couldn't talk in my own room. They see me and they didn't bring me up. If Pink Sugar had not have came in there, I would have still been in the ghoul with the spectators and my own shit. So when I said, you know what? I had Pink, yo, you don't see him dying? She said, oh shit, why the fuck they ain't bring you up? I said, bring me up. They brought me up. We couldn't maneuver. When I got back in, I was going boom in the room. Somebody else did it for me. And they put it in there. Yo, listen, if somebody want to know who boom in the room, tell them I did it. I didn't say nothing. You why? I ain't no rat. You want to know? Ask a question instead of jump out the window. Mirror, CK, you wouldn't let me up. I wasn't the one keeping stats down in the goo. That wasn't me. All right? The same person that boomed that room is the same person that kept him in the goo. They didn't like how he was talking to me. But at that point, we all was laughing. You know why? I called it, man. I called it. Once that Kobe and Shaq shit started, I said, yo, the nigga stats is allowing this fucking cornball, allowing this cornball to influence him. I said, in a minute, Stat's gonna be on Oppie time. I said, we need to have a motherfucking a hybrid meeting to get him so we can get a sense. Yo, bro, you starting to like verbally attack the team. Like, chill out, bro. But before we can do that, he was too far gone. So I said, you know what, y'all? When we get a chance, we need to talk. I don't want to fucking backbite him. I need to let him know, nigga, you get ready to start going against the team. It was too late. He was already too far gone. Started getting crazy, this and that, or whatever case may be. So I told everybody, do me a favor, just stay out of his way for a minute. He got to be able to see that he just met this dude. He don't know the dude from a hole of Adam. He's not your friend. You met him online. What are you doing, bro? But I let him rock out. Meanwhile, I'm having meetings with Chris Gotti. I got Atlantic Record meetings. I got a dude that not sure everybody know about it, right? Look, you see Big Mix saying big facts, right? Right, Atlantic Records. Atlantic Records. We got a Fetty Wap feature. I can play the song Fetty Wap joint right now for y'all. We got a Fetty Wap feature. You know what I'm saying? That I pulled to be on, they sent the feature to me. Ask Nitro what I did. I said, nah, Nitro, your album coming out before mine's. Here, you take the Fetty Wap feature. How the fuck am I playing it? How the fuck am I I'm the one playing everybody? But I'm making all my moves, sacrifices for the team. I can't help that I already got a bag, bro. When your niggas is in your sleep, I'm up moving around. Harlem W ain't no shot. You know what I mean? Yeah, you can even ask Sean Boy Double on them. They gonna say day in, day out, only thing CK, I mean, right? Only thing CK do is talk about my team. Shout 120. You what, nigga? Shout a little assassin, blah, 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 that. She go whip niggas head and they catch it, they come back. Boom. That's all I do. I've never, never talked against my family and my team. They right now, Shy had to justify what he did. Nigga, you can never, ever, maybe you didn't mean it, Shy, but you can never agree to disagree with a sucker, bro, because he threw you under the bus. I sent you the message from Nigel, said, yo, nigga just said Shy said you lying. Know what I mean? You know what I mean? See what the homie said? He can't return. Okay, of course he can't return, homie. You see, I ain't got no remorse for the nigga. I don't give a fuck if the nigga live or die at this point. I'm not going to kill him. I'm not going to kill him. But nor am I going to kill myself. Feed into his nonsense. Y'all know I'm the pull-up king. Y'all know what I do. You know these shits work and the ever instrument work as well. But why would I fuck with a nigga, a lower level nigga who I was trying to build up and give him more fucking new, a new perspective on life? Nigga, I didn't need you. Nigga, you came to my movement. Hybrid is my movement. Hybrid is Nitro movement. Hybrid is Shy 120. He's a bird. Shy Nigga, he's a bird. But Hybrid is Shy 120 movement. We don't know you, nigga. We embraced you, nigga, because a team member came and we loyal to Nitro. So when he brought you, we became loyal to you. You understand what I'm saying? But nigga, I don't owe none of you niggas nothing. The only nigga who helped me pay the paper shit is fucking Nitro and Ace Boogie. Cause yeah, behind the scene, everybody with CK, yeah, you ought to be paying for the mix downs you had. Let me send at least $200 in there. Cause that's what Ace Boogie do. And ask him what I do. I take his money because I want to make it for he's not a motherfucking valid man. I take his money. And I always find a way to send that shit back to him. Look at Sean Trapp. We got Sean Trapp. For those that don't know, Sean Trapp been had a motherfucking a feature with Beanie Siegel. You know what I'm saying? He been had a feature with Beans. He's hybrid. You got Ratchet Rico, one of the nicest niggas moving right now. He hybrid. He on Big Rob from Jersey. He's hybrid. He's on the mixtape. That's him, Fetty Wap, and now Nitro. They gave me the feature, and I passed it on to Lil Bro. Now, Lil Bro, hey, you take the feature. You coming out first. I miss doing what I'm doing on the hybrid project. Then after that, I'm dropping one more CK mixtape. You know what I'm saying? One more CK mixtape. And then after that, I'm back scene doing what I do. Traveling, knocking on doors to open more fucking doors for my family, my team. Like I started out doing, they made me hit the booth. I wasn't in the booth. They made me get in the booth. And that family, Lord, their family pride made me get in the booth and give niggas my best shot. You understand what I'm saying? I was just trying to put money behind the situation. I wasn't going there with niggas. But time and time again, a nigga get know what I mean? That's right. That's right. Yeah, I was getting the Z-Crate shot. Z-Crate. But my thing is, time and time again, these niggas take to the internet and start screaming and yelling like I did something to them. That's what I ever asked for. Ask them if you ever gave me any money. Ask them. Ask him if I ever stole anything from him. Ask him if I fucked his bitch. Because the way you screaming and yelling bloody motherfucking hell and bloody Mary, you would think I did something to the nigga. I ain't do nothing to the nigga. All I did was not kick Warbrim out of Eastern District. That's it. And it warrant all that, the screaming and yelling? It really warrant all that? You know what I mean? You got motherfucking Z-Crate. You know what I mean? Z-Crate got his own motherfucking night spot situation going on. My son get to a fucking super bag. Why me and him not falling out? And on my birthday, he's giving money. We in the strip club on my birthday, wilding, and my son said, yo, here, and gave me 1,000 motherfucking ones. Gave me $1,000 in ones. Here, big homie. Happy birthday, nigga. Put your money up, nigga. Boom, it's on me. Here. Boom. And you know what I did right in front of him? He didn't get mad. He respected it. I took 500, and the little homies next to me, I gave them the other 500 so they could have some ones to throw. You understand what I'm saying? But I'm the foul nigga. I'm wrong. You know how much love I have for this nigga, Stats? I had mad love for this nigga, bro. You know, I see them do the song together, The Human Made Concern. I specifically called, I could have easily said, yo, Shy, hop on this song. And let Shy hop on and wear it out. Yo, Nitro, give me a verse. No, I said, yo, Stats, this is me and your song, bro. We doing this. You know what I'm saying? Because I really checked for the nigga, homie. I don't hate that nigga right now. I'm a little confused and bothered because in my eyes, I always see him as a smart nigga. Stats is a very intellectual motherfucker. So I'm thinking, yo, he had enough motherfucking poise and sense to analyze when a nigga was coming through trying to break our shit like a pool table, bro. Joe Button said it, I always say this line. When you bring a nerd to the pool table, to the cool table, when you bring a nerd to the cool table, shit is bound to break up like a pool table. Joe Buttons, man. How fucking real is that? Yeah, dang, I see a shot there. Y'all got the Lion King, right? Appreciate it, man. You know what I mean? But that's another thing. You know, I've been drippy way before YouTube and all that. My whole life I've been a drippy nigga. Why now niggas hold it against me every time they see me in some new threads? Why I can't be every bit of the boss that I am? I earned this shit, bro. I earned this shit. You know what I mean? I said Mendes is one, so I had to do one better than his shit. So when he got his shit, I went and got the lion skin joint, nigga, with the motherfucking fur around it. This ain't lion fur. This is that real thing right here. See how it's shaped? This is that real fur right here. But the coat, lion skin, nigga. You know what I mean? Lion skin, nigga. To make sure that them saying, Mendes, my son. Shout out to Mendes, right? But to show my niggas, yeah, big homie still on it. Big homie still up. Big homie still up. Big homie still doing his numbers. You know what I'm saying? Every time I bust a bankroll and bust out 10 bands, 8 bands, 30 bands, whatever I bust out, it's not the shit or to offend my team. My team supposed to know that money represents them. So any nigga who take offense to that is an inside hater. You see how that works? If you take offense to your man, get into an issue, you're an inside hater. And the whole time, popcorn. whole time popcorn with my nuts on his chin and all that. Stats sat in the room with him on the panel. I ain't attacked Stats not one time. What you call it, me disloyal? Let's be real. Let me go deal with the facts now. Every time Popcorn has some disrespectful shit to say towards me, gay big homie, CK this and that, so on and so forth. Stats sat in that room for months on end. Go back to them videos. I'm encouraging her to go back and get Popcorn the views and look at the videos. Stats is only at 2-3 hours with this nigga while he dissing me. But you hybrid, but you loyal to me. Me and Jazzo had a fallout because I wouldn't kick Stats 280 out of hybrid. Do you remember that shot 120? Nitro? On the CK4 from Graces? Cause I wouldn't flip on Stats. But you loyal to me. I wasn't never loyal to you. You see what I'm talking about? Everybody said they remember exactly Harlem Double. Right? Loyal to you though. Yo, don't let them broadcast on your channel. No, this is what I'm going to do, Stats. Doing regular hours. You know, I get in the daytime. Disrespect my slot. Ask Nigel and Acing them. Respect my morning time slot. I should have to get on and you online. When I get on, I cut you off by me logging on. So respect my morning time slot and you can have the midnight run. You remember that? They was on that little vibe, that little midnight vibe and all that shit. You know what I mean? I never turned on that man. But when he kept on going on, I get big brother, says, yo, Stats, it's too repetitious now. Yo, move on, bro. Or if you want to do that, then create your channel based off of that. This ain't what, yeah, the rec room. This ain't what the 212 channel represent, bro. Don't feel like I'm flipping on you. You welcome. He still got access to my channel, bro. Because I genuinely have love for son. I ain't changed none of that shit up because I got love for son. You know what I mean? Even now, I'm mad as fuck at him. I want to fight this nigga. But I'd rather shoot the fire with him, let him get off his chest, sit down, reflect what he did. So this way, in the future, he'll do better with somebody else. You know what I mean? Because he's truly validating me for no reason at all, bro. For no reason at all. Even Ward Brimson, your CK. Damn, niggas wanted to vote me off while you ain't tell me. In the room, everything is going on. Because it slipped my mind, bro. My mind is on getting this hybrid project put out there. You know what I'm saying? I seen all the people sending me links to sit there and say, I don't give a fuck. I'm not on here to try to get at Stats. I'm gonna call them pussy this and that. Popcorn to them, suck my dick. All your niggas. Eat a dick. Fuck y'all. You know what I mean? But any nigga that was hybrid, any nigga that called my team member, that was pure love and pure intentions. So even though you doing what you doing online, I'm not going at you like that. That ain't how I maneuver. Are you being a bozo? Yeah, you being a bozo. I'm gonna call you a bozo. But me calling you a bitch, dick sucker, you ain't got to worry about that. That's not what I do. I'm a real nigga. I'm a lawyer. I'm a representation of what lawyer look like. And because you're not lawyer, you couldn't see that. I mean, you know what? CK do his one and two, but CK stay up out of our shit. I let you have your moment. I let you do y'all, my nigga, until I feel like it's going too far. Then and only then do I super. All right? I know you're going to watch it. You may not admit you're going to, but you're going to watch it. So yeah, babe, bro, you wrong, man. You took to the internet on some wrong shit. Listen to Lamonte. Because he's a miserable motherfucker. You have to listen to his conversation. This nigga attacks everybody. Yo, man, this and that, man. Fuck out of here, man. He had a personal beef with Rack 100. Me and Rack 100 beef was a riff in the beef. Every season we probably would have fought. But we did what grown men do. He went out his way to understand what my problem was. Contrary to clickbaiting, I did have a problem with the Jim Jones shit, but I told him, yo, bro, we don't know if Jimmy told nobody. Yeah, we heard the tape and all that shit, but until I see paperwork, I always kept this position. Until I see paperwork, I can't call that man no rat. And you're never gonna see nowhere and hear anything where CK said, that nigga's a rat. I didn't do that. The clickbaiters put it out there like that. They gave you pieces and feed of tape recordings to make it seem, since a whack a plant, to make it seem like I was jacking and co-signing. You know what I mean? Yeah, look, since I remember all that. Exactly, homie. You know what I mean? I'm saying, bully ball. Like, I made it clear, yo, bro, and I did the same shit with Casanova. You didn't cast one, so now Cass ain't gonna tell. And we not gonna have those conversations about Cass. You know what I'm saying? That's the position I always take. Boom, look at the Star Brim situation. Schemo pull we put out there. We fell out because I told him, yo, my nigga, you can't be doing what you're doing. Why you doing that? And I ain't know whether he was wrong or right. I just know I don't backbite my family, man. My homies. I don't do that. You know what I mean? With Nori, we cursed out. I shot a shot at Nori. But when I found out she told Nori suck her dick, I apologized to the man. Why? As anybody under my family, my regime, they know better. You don't do that. Once you tell a motherfucker suck your dick, popcorn suck my dick. Right? Once you do that, you pulled the mean that shit. You know what I'm saying? Popcorn suck my dick. You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day or whatever, it is what it is. But my thing is, like a G, I'm a man, homie. I'm not gonna kill a nigga to impress y'all. I'm not gonna get Jay Savage. I gotta get him. He called me gay big homie. So everything I have to say to him is suck my dick, nigga. You know what I mean? What man stalks a nigga name the way this man called my name? Eat a dick, faggot. Anyway, at the end of the day, my thing is this way here, right? I'm not sitting around talking about nigga. I mean, yeah, he don't be outside for real. I seen the dude not too long. I said, yo, you see K, right? Yo, man, I watch you every morning. Yo, bro, yeah, you outside for real. I been a never store. Shop, a nigga see me. Yo, bro, you outside for real. He said, and you keep them big faces, nigga. Yeah, you don't be playing. Because he see me busting up 10 bands on the coat. You know what I'm saying? With more bands to share, because I bust it up when I bust it up, man. But my thing is, niggas, whether they do it intentionally or unintentionally, keep stabbing me in my back for no reason, bro. You know what I'm saying? That's why I gave Shy room to wiggle. Maybe you didn't mean it the way it came out. Maybe he took what you said the wrong way. But the point is, he told Nitro that you said I was lying. That's why I went to Clubhouse to ask you, Shy 120, Wall Brim, Whack 100 in a week. Yo, did I contact y'all about that? Was I in those, you know what I mean? Was I in those conversations? Shy said no. This is what confused me, because Shy ain't hesitating. Nah, she can't have nothing to do with that. He tried to squash it. Whack said no. Week said no. Week said, man, Whack said, man, that shit got nothing to do with Corey. Whack was lost. But he was trying to argue with me for Lamonte. Nah, I was in the room with Lamonte. Man, ain't got nothing to do with you, man. Yo, you did the wrong way. I said, no. Then when he heard the conversation, he said, yo, he even told Stats, man, you need to fix that situation with Corey King. You dead wrong. I never had no parts in the conversation. Whatever Shy and Whack talked about, Shy, Whack, and Wall Brim, CK was out here doing what I'm doing right now. Up early, get me some motherfucking Super Sun for breakfast. Cause yeah, I'm on a diet now. I'm eating bad veggies and oriental food, shit like that or whatever. Cause there is no sodium in that shit. Ain't no rice, I eat none of that shit. Cause it's time for me to get myself back in shape and get right. You know I got a fight coming up. You know what I'm saying? Cause the boy, the older boy outside, man. Yeah, the older boy outside. You know what I'm saying? They can say what they want, but older boy outside. But my thing is, I don't understand how it go from me not wanting to kick a nigga out of a fucking app, a fucking online bullshit app. I'm like, yo, Stats, this is me, nigga. What are you doing? Trying to plead with nigga now because I was scared I'm trying to wake him up. Nigga, this is me, nigga. You hung outside with me, nigga. You let a nigga that's not outside turn you against me. I'm outside with you, nigga. Wake up. You know what I mean? He not getting it. He too lost in his motherfucking heyday trying to be the nigga who show up CK. You just told the whole world you disloyal, you nigga. Nigga seen you outside with me, not that nigga. I sat down and ate food with you, not that nigga. You know what I mean? Come on, bro. Come on. You know what I'm saying? You mean see when Fab on his song, he said, I'm outside with the older boy, he talking about prom. I had a little, small little debate with Fab. Prom is my flesh and blood cousin. That nigga got mad as fuck at me. Why, that's his boy, that's his dog. And even against me, he protected his dog. That's what I call that blind faith, that loyalty. When you willing to go against any and everybody. I use that example. Why? Cause I didn't understand, yo, nigga, I'm only fucking with Fab. I ain't trying to hurt the nigga, I'm just fucking with him. Papa said to him, nigga, chill out. Cause Fab is family, nigga, support family, nigga. Nigga, I die for that nigga. Nigga, ain't nobody gonna hurt Fab out here in these streets. You know what I mean? But it's just the fact, Prom didn't like how I was fucking with him. I talk and say, yo, Fab, but yeah. Nigga, why you over here? Come over here with us. Just fucking with him. You know what I'm saying? He smiled. Fab know I ain't mean that. He to me, hey. Like, this nigga CK, get the fuck on fucking with me. Me, him, Red Cafe, you know what I'm saying? We on the boat ride. I wasn't trying to hurt Fab, I was talking my shit to him. I love Fab, nigga. Come on, let's be real. You know what I'm saying? But it's the principle that Prime took offense to that shit and really went at his older cousin. I'm older than Prime. He went at me. Yo, nigga, I'm telling you, this and that. Then everybody said happy birthday to him. He forgot all about his birthday to say, yo, CK, you know what? You a goon. I give you that. You a gorilla. I give you that. But gorillas only get bananas. And the whole boat, Dick Wolf said, what? Anybody go to the water? And start trying to throw niggas in the water all type of shit. Because he felt the way he could probably suspect me. It's all fact. There's niggas that's on that boat, including Fat Red Cafe Lava, your words, CK ain't lying. Remember that shit? You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, Fat is least that. Bananas. You know what I'm saying? But my thing is, yeah, he went there. You know what I'm saying? He went there. So, this video that did this stats is to get my side of the story out so the whole world can know, yo, CK ain't even now, he never even beefing with stats. That nigga Lamonte is a buster. He's a mark. Fuck him. You know what I mean? Popcorn, eat a motherfucker homo with AIDS ass. You do that and die, nigga. I mean, how motherfucking OG Pilot said, you a waste man, pussy. You know what I mean? Care about no outsider. Fuck the outside niggas. But I'm going to get my shit off now. Now it's time for me to let the world know why these niggas is taking off on me. For no reason at all. It's just such an easy thing to do. Why? Once you, a nigga be around me, nigga around CK, you know this nigga CK is an extremely smart nigga. He ain't jumping out no window. He ain't dumb. He got too much going on. He worked too hard for shit. I never did want to clarify that was said. I never said I owned a hotel. Do I have a big stake in the hotel? Of course I do. I never said I was sole owner anything. I never said I owned the King's Theater. Y'all know that. Do I have a stake in the King's Theater? Of course I do. I can show you the emails where the email come due for the lineup. I never valet cars. None of my staff or workers valet cars. Where security, perimeter security, being the parking lot and outside the theater, I have a security business, for those that don't know. It's called King Management and Training Group. Pull it up. You'll see my name. You'll see a location that I use for a business address and all that shit. Because you got to have a business address in order to complete your corporation. I got stamps. Do I got my stamp? I got business stamps and everything, bro. So, for a nigga to say I'm capping, yeah, I got my stamp up. For a nigga to say I'm capping, I don't understand how I'm capping. Nigga, all my shit is in black and white. Them chicks say one thing on it. King Management and Training Group. You see this? You see this, right? Look at the name on this shit. How am I capping? How am I capping? Business step. How am I capping, bro? I don't get it. I don't get it. What conversation you had with what hater? I don't get it. You can't make it up. How am I capping? All that shit, the King's Theater, the hotel, all that fall under this corporate umbrella. Why? Okay, yeah, bus driver, you fucking up. Why? Because it was designed that way. Why'd you beeping the horn in this big-ass bus in front of us, dog? Let's just be real now. Come on, you gonna hit the car right here or something stupid? Niggas is dumb. You beeping your horn with a big-ass bus in front of us. Anyway, at the end of the day, though, show me where my cap is at. You know what I mean? You call me a liar, I can show you 1,000 facts, homie. Get it? You can't make this up. And that's just a sticker, right? But now, how do you make the stamp? Because the stamps say the same shit. How do you make that up? I don't sign checks. I stamp it and deposit them. All right? Just to put people in my business. This is why I'm so motherfucking drippy and got shit going on. You know what I mean? Because I work hard for this shit. I had a regular job and everybody fucking else. But I had a game plan and a motherfucking aim, and I followed my dream. I ain't follow your dream. I ain't follow her dream or his dream. I followed my dream. And even though in the beginning, C-Man, certain shit was failing, that failure opened the door to something that was actually working. And when that came to a motherfucking end, it was a never lane open that took me to the next level. And I opened the never lane, it took me to the next level. I got a song called Go Getter. Talking about females who basically come out, want to live your lifestyle, so on and so forth. Want the ring, the car, all that shit. And you catch the bitches cheating and all that shit. You know what I mean? I mean, she was a go getter. You know what I mean? Boom. I did that shit in motherfucking in Rap-A-Lot Studios. Let me pull over while I'm talking to y'all. I did that shit in Rap-A-Lot Studios, bro. You know what I mean? And guess who makes my shit down? The legendary Mike Dean. Nigga, this all gonna be proven. It's facts. It's documented. So I ain't just start trying to do music. I've been around this shit the whole time I've been home. Since 2004, I came on 2003, since 2004, I was down in Houston, Texas. Under the name Gucci Spoons. But they cut it short, but just called me Spoons. New York Spoons, even Spoons. So show me where I'm capping at. I don't get it. Yo, you don't respond. How you gonna tell a motherfucking seasoned veteran how the fuck he supposed to respond? You niggas on the internet screaming, hooping, and hollering, y'all responding the wrong way, bro. Because if niggas was really about that life, you wouldn't take to the internet to holler at me, nigga. I'm on this phone right here. So I can take my messages, my text messages, and show y'all what I'm saying. When you get through with the internet shit, my nigga, I'm waiting on you. Where we pulling up at? I'm in New York. What's up? Where we pulling up to? Where we meeting at? Yo, stop texting my phone. You know what I mean? Facts, David Soto. I had a dream like Biggie, homie. And I'm living my shit. My son said, what feet I got on? You want to see what feet I got on, Mike? Let me see if I can do it, because this coat and shit is kind of dickin'. Let me see if I can back up a little bit. I mean, see, that's what I like. When niggas say, yo, what you got on your feet, CK? They wanna see what the older boy got on his feet. See what the older boy got on his feet, man. They wanna see what the older boy look. See what I'm talking about? Some niggas appreciate what the older boy rocking. Look what the older boy got on his feet, bro. Look at the older boy. You know what I mean? Why are you calling me? Yeah, I want the older boy got on his feet. You know what I mean? Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, what you got on your feet, CK? You see how he's had, see how a nigga just gave it drip up? You know what I mean? Look at the belt piece and all that. She had an older boy give it up. You know what I'm saying? But that's why they mad. My son said, fire. That's why they mad. You know why? They won't put the work in. They won't put the work in to wear Gucci boots in the wintertime. You know what I'm saying? They won't do that to get the motherfucking fur. You see my shit all the way through authentic. They won't do that. You know why? They rather sit around and expect you to hand them something. Nigga mad at me because he said I didn't give him nothing. Nigga, all that studio time cost. And I'm talking up. And I'm talking about when I'm not around, I'm out of town. And like, yo, bro, I want to record, bro. But I ain't really got no bread. Yo, hey, I record jugs. That shit lined up. But I never gave a nigga nothing. You know what I mean? Exactly. I just hired a nigga yesterday. I hired my man. My man Smoke is a gangster. I said, yo, Smoke, I got X, Y, Z. He get money. He said, hell yeah. I said, what? $500 a week? Give me that. That's extra pocket change for me to do what I do with my car. My car. Nigga at working. He working at 8 to 4. He go to work. So my thing is, why, man? Why can't black people wait? This is where the illest shit come in now. Why can't black people wait, man? We don't never give nothing time to develop before we bite the finger that's trying to feed us. You know what I mean? Shah, that's why it's important to get there. Exactly, Shah. Why you saying that? This is what I'm trying to point out. Why you ain't check that nigga? You let that whole shit, now I'm talking to you, Shah, you let that whole shit snowball and turn into an avalanche, but all you had to do is say, yo, stats, you see that the wrong way, bro. She can't got nothing to do with none of this shit. You said you want to do a vote, then do a vote, but you can't blame homie. That's not, you know me better than anybody, Shah. That's not how CK operate. He's not going to turn around and take nobody's side. You know this. You know this. That's why I'm really mad at you. Brother, you said I was lying and now who cares, sir? Who gives a fuck? You know I ain't had no opinion in conversation to lie. I wasn't a part of it. So I didn't have an opinion or a statement in there to lie about. Besides calling your phone because Wall Brim was talking hot about you. I said, stop, bro. What? We not doing it with my bro. And I got you on the phone. If I'm guilty for that, you know what I mean? That's it. But I'm mad at you because when he first started expressing his feelings, you should have said, yo, bro, what? Stop. CK Dawn, a good example. And Nitro pointed this out to me. When me and Nitro were talking. He said, yo, CK, niggas don't realize because of who you are and the person you are and what you stand for, you in a position whether you like it or not. Damn if you do, damn if you don't. If you don't take your time and analyze the situation and you just hop out there, you got the potential of getting somebody hurt or fucking the whole situation up. He said, so I respect the fact that you don't get involved and said you analyze it and then you come through and you try to make it make sense. Now that you were younger, why he so smart? Nitro was a youngin', why is he so smart? Why you older niggas don't get it? Whether I like it or not, I am Corey King. I done graduated to such a level where my opinion matters. I'm not with the shits. I'm not on no street time and all that. I'm trying to get money the right way. I don't sell cocaine. I don't sell heroin. I do not sell gun. It's not my practice to run around carrying guns. You know what I mean? That's a fact. And guess what? That's what I do, bro. I try to make peace, right? But even with Shah, He get frustrated and mad. I go, yo, Sean, chill. This is why I do that with Sean. Sean can be 100% right. This is where, Sean, we don't care about you owning your own whole house and that, right? Because you still trying to combat, nigga. Shut the fuck up and eat this shit, nigga. All right? That's that. All that ever, y'all own my own house, that's that. Nigga, we don't care about none of that. They ain't got nothing to do with what we talking about right now. You still with this trying to compare. Don't compete with me, see? I'm a different nigga, homie. I keep trying to show you that. By doing the house. Yeah, whatever. Yeah, you're right, Sean. It's important for you to have your own. But when you get your own, you don't change in a motherfucker who never changed on you when you ain't have your own. Nigga. This is why I keep telling you, chill out. Because you trying to fight it. When you ain't have shit, I was your friend. I was your friend. If you ate a crackhead soup, I ate a crackhead soup with money in my pocket. To show you we was the same nigga. Remember those days? I want oxtails, but you just want some simple shit? And I damn near forced you to eat oxtails with me? Remember that? You see, Cal, I'm eating all that shit. I don't eat like that, bro. My system. Remember, I didn't understand your sickness? Trying to force you to eat? That's your friend, bro. Remember in the casino? I said, you know what? I'm going to break you on. So I hit that shit. So I walked away and you hit the jackpot, the major jackpot for me. I ain't break you off, bro. I didn't trust and believe in you to take that last pick. I ain't about what I do for you. I'm trying to remind you of your brother, nigga. I had that much faith and trust in you that you know I'm a gambling nigga. I gamble on my own hands. I trusted your hands, y'all. Hit a CK, sit a CK. I said, nah, I ain't doing that. I said, Shaw, this your moment. I believe you, bro. Get it, bro. And Shaw hit it. She said, major jackpot. And we hit the major jackpot. Get it? We hit the major jackpot. I spent that money three ways between me, Shaw, and my chick. This is the point I'm trying to make to y'all. I get misrepresented, lied on, and dogged out so much that this is the reason why I have these videos. Because niggas forget those moments right there. They forget that. You remember when I lost all my weed, shout who I call? Niggas ain't know I lost a bunch of motherfucking weed. When my cousin Prime died, he basically died on me a bunch of weed. He dead, so I don't want to talk about it. I don't, like they say, my bad mother, a dead man, but yeah, he never paid for a bunch of weed he took from me. Then I turned around and lost a bunch of ever weed in the box, shooting the box across. It had $1,000 to my name because I invested everything trying to go heavy. Being real with y'all, I can do it now. Trying to go heavy so I can recoup what I lost with his demise, recoup for me taking care of everything around me. So the dude said, nigga only gave me $150, $200. Be happy I gave you something, bro. Cause when y'all finished with the woes and the eyes, this and that, crying about the bullshit about why I don't give y'all, what about my motherfucking 8 kids, nigga? No, I'm lying. 28 kids. Cause yeah, any woman that I ever dealt with, even though I don't deal with her, I still hold 8 kids down. The kids still call me Pop or even call me Corey, and they can call me for anything, and I send it to them. I done help people pay their children tuition, only for them to turn around and do some creepy, sneaky shit and get caught. And I cut them the fuck off, but still make sure if their kids call me, I show shorty of them love. Why? It doesn't have anything to do with the children. A child can't be held accountable for something that a grown adult does. Until this day, I got about 28 kids, my nigga. Not all women that I fuck with. Nieces, nephews, people that can call me and rely on me to tip that rebound for them. Yeah, that part. That's what the shit I'm pointing at. You know what I mean? That's what I'm pointing out. When I'm traveling and shit with niggas and they getting cramps in their stomach and they can't maneuver, and I'm like, yo, we ain't going if homie don't get right. Remember those moments, nigga. Are you playing Ohio Mighty and you playing victim? Remember those moments. The moments where everybody, yo, fuck it. Yo, put him in the cab and we got a fence. I'm like, nah, my nigga, if Shy don't go, we don't go, nigga. Think about that. Think about when we going somewhere and it's 8-9 of us and I ain't asking who got money. I go in my pocket and say, yo, it's 10 of us. Even though most places we got it free, but it's probably we didn't. I don't say, yo, you got money by this. Yo, it's 10 of us. How much is that? In fact, how much for a section? So we all get in a section. Oh, the section is 400. It come with a bottle. But if you give us 700, we'll put three bottles on your table and everybody get in. So I do that. I take that number, boom, and rock that way. What about those nights? What about those nights? Mr. I can give you everything you ever gave me on one hand. What about those nights? What's up, Kenya? See, Kenya said facts. What I do every year, Kenya? I didn't do it this year. Kind of get up here in time. But what do I do for the kids every year? You know what I mean? Yeah, look, y'all. Now, as Sharon, y'all watch this. Only people that could motherfucking, I mean, yeah, that's the whole purpose of the show, y'all. You see what he just said? Never expose the family for everybody. This is what I'm trying not to do. But Sha, keep getting in the middle. Shut the fuck up. I'm not fucking with you. You know what I mean? The call out number's here. The call out line is here. Anybody want to call, you can call up. Feel free. My thing is, it's not aimed at Sha. If you notice, I keep telling popcorn, suck my dick. You know what I mean? But at the end of the day, that's where it ended. I ain't even tell stats that. I ain't afraid of stats. Because I'm a loyal nigga. Even though we ain't fucking with each other, I'm not gonna get on the internet and lie. If I start dissing that nigga, then know what that mean? I'm lying, you know why? That ain't how I feel, and that ain't who Stats is. He ain't no bitch. Stats been running clubs, and we giving 10 clubs together. I know he ain't a bitch, but my thing is he's lying. He calling me out my name crazy. That ain't what we do. Top of the game, 212 with me.
Yeah, why you never give me a chance to defend myself, man? You so quick to attack me.
Because it's not about you, Sean.
I never say nothing bad about you. I never disrespect you. I stay loyal like a dog to the very end.
How, Sean? Listen to me, Sean. Listen.
I told him the last time I was online, all these niggas talking this homo shit about my brother and all this foul shit, they making up. Like, you got me fucked up, bro. I just
want to
die.
All right, I get it, Michelle. Why you even do that? No, why you even do that with Stash though? So I love it. He's wrong. He caught in the middle of it. Everybody know he caught in the middle of it. Stash is not going to say Shy 120 says CK is lying if that ain't what happened. I asked about Stash. Yo, I love you. Why you can't say that about Stash? Because that puts you further. Because you know Stash is a Mad Hatter. What Shy you fronting that's gonna make Stats get online? I address everything, you know why? I ain't lying. I ain't do nothing. I ain't had nothing to do with none of the conversation. So apparently, you can't talk about it and say Stats is lying, because then it's gonna make Stats get online and say you lying. Y'all play a basic game, nigga. Yeah, I'm in Flatbush, my nigga. Me, I'm different. I'm a mental nigga. This is why I get those big corporate checks and all that. I'm a mental nigga. I'm a street nigga with a fucking corporate mind. So when you're playing this little bullshit, lower level, quarter water game, nigga, I'm playing the Ace of Spades game, nigga. You know what I mean? Bottom line, that's it. So I got on here to address the situation, man. That's it. Stop calling my name in vain. Stop involving me in shit I don't have nothing to do with. That shit was between Shy 120, it was between Wall Brim, it was between Stats 280 and Lamonte Sims and Wack 100. It started with Wack. So right there, do this right here, look. And lock that circle in. That's it. Niggas just do CK and some shit that had nothing to do. I wasn't even there for the conversation. When Wackin' was arguing, I wasn't there. When Wall Brim did his shit about Wack, I wasn't there. Don't you get it? I'm nowhere around. So how the fuck do I get caught in the middle to the point where Stats is taken to the internet calling my name in vain? I don't get it. You see what Zoom Man said? You sure wasn't there. I wasn't there. So how I'm the culprit? But let me tell you about clout chasing. Sometimes you can sit around and watch a nigga get all the attention effortlessly without trying to get attention, just being who he is on a day-to-day. Nigga, I woke up like this. You know what I'm saying? I ain't doing it out the ordinary. I ain't online exposing niggas. I ain't online screaming and cursing at the top of my lungs at any and everybody who come into my chat rooms. You know what I'm saying? Could you start going to the back? In any and every chat room. You know what I mean? That ain't what I do. That is not what I do. I'm not here to hurt nobody's feelings. I'm not here to get nobody hurt. I'm not here to hate on nobody. On a normal basis, I don't want to fight nobody until people start fucking with me. Why the rest of the team adore me? They make like, yo, what? That's my CK, but we love, bro. You know why? I don't do what these clown niggas is accusing me of. Nitro come through, he fly over California. You know what happens? Nitro control the studio. Yo, I had an idea right here. Yo, boom. I call him Nah. Go ahead, Nah. Do your thing. Boom. You know what I'm saying? We don't do that, bro. When Nitro come on board, I let them young niggas be young niggas. I don't stop nobody. Don't tell nobody what they should say at their mouth. I don't tell them what beat to use. They do them. To make a nigga feel like you don't support him is the worst thing in the world you could do to a man, bro. And that's what these niggas be doing behind the scene. Me and Shaw always have a riff-raff. Why? I tell Shaw, nah, you nice, nigga. I don't like the music you make. I think you got too, put too emotional shit, but I know really you a lyrical bully. Am I lying, Shaw? Because you seem to have a hesitation. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Shaw, you was just on the phone. Why you texting? You called my phone. Say it's my. It was your fault. This is why, Shaw. I'm going to say that after this, I don't want to keep arguing with you no more. You are an elder. You're older than me, nigga. You an elder. When you hear a youngster that may have it twisted with another elder, you pull the talk logic to him to make him see where he may be, maybe causing an error. Before he crash and burn, you don't let him crash and burn. The first one pulled to be on you, bro. Yo, bro, listen. Nah, you saying that wrong. I ain't gonna lie. Corey always been like that. You heard Killer Cap said it. CK ain't the type of jump out the window. He gonna sit down and he gonna think about it for a minute. KK said that. You an elder, bro. I know you're not being disrespectful, so I'm not being disrespectful either. And I don't mean to keep saying you shut the fuck up. I just want you to think, bro. Think. You an elder, and Stats respect you, bro. He fuck with you. So once he got it twisted with me, you put it and say, right there, now you going wrong. Well, listen, that's how Corey is. Corey is a mental nigga, and he's somewhat of an introvert. Think about it, Sal. Remember, I just now started talking online. I wasn't even a talking nigga. Everybody said that, yo, she can't quiet nigga. You got to watch him. You see that smile come out? It may not be a smile. You got to be careful with CK. He'll smile and pop off. Remember those conversations nigga was talking about? I'm not that dude no more. Now I sit down, I analyze shit, and I get it off my chest so that I don't have a problem with a nigga in the future. All I'm saying is I should have been given more of the benefit of the doubt, being that I never violated nobody, I never lied, If I couldn't do something, I'm like, yo, bro, that ain't gonna happen this week, but don't worry, I got it next week. You feel me? That's all I'm saying. What happened to giving me the benefit of the doubt, the same I give all you niggas, but you know, come on, Shy, you know I argue with you all day. Yo, Shy, you shouldn't have did that. Fuck that, Corey. I don't like how he talking to you. Tell me what I'm saying, something wrong, Shy. I'm not here to stress the truth. I'm here to talk facts, baby. How many times did I leave you frustrated and mad at me because you thought I didn't understand you was representing me? But the rational thinking stepped in before irrational thinking. And so I was thinking rational to the point I said, yo, bro, I appreciate your loyalty, but yo, you didn't have to do that, Shy. Let these niggas say what they want to say. Fuck that, bro. We're going to show them something different. How many times I made you frustrated because I debated that point all the way home, even though you wanted to get right crazy to the point where I started on the nigga's side. No, wait. Because I didn't want you to say no crazy shit. I appreciate the loyalty, but is it really worth it? This is how I think. I go into, is it worth it? If we take off on this man, are we losing a valuable asset? Let's say I would have said, yo, fuck out of here. Get out of here, war, bro. Get out of here. Fuck you. Would that have been the best calculated move? This is how I think. I don't just move off emotions. I ask myself these questions. You know what I mean? It sounds like he just wants some views. Right? I'm just saying, me flipping on Shy 120, is that the best possible move? Yeah, it'll give me a bunch of hits. Yo, CK took off on Shy. He called them all kind of goofies and bozo, Frank Stanley. Yeah, it'd be 2,000 people in here for that. It's 200 people in here right now. I'm content with that. I don't gotta have the 9,088 motherfuckers in my room ever mean I gotta disrespect my brother. That's why I'm not dissing stats. Cause I bet you any amount of money, that nigga gonna stop and think and say, yo, you know what? Yeah, I really took off on this nigga for no reason. I didn't realize that this is who CK is. CK think about everything. I think about everything. Even when there ain't no beef going on, I'm thinking how to prevent the beef that I see get may take place. Because I watch everything, bro. And I watch everybody around me. How do I prevent this shit from jumping off? Because I'm watching the frustration between these niggas. Should I even approach it? Maybe I approach it. It might take its own life form and go there anyway. But then if I don't approach it and they go there, then I'm wrong for not stopping it. See the situation I'm in? Damn if I do, damn if I don't. You know what I mean? That's it. You know? I ain't paying you no mind, Sacker. You just still on defense mode. Once again, this live is not about you. Nigga, sit your old ass down, man. I ain't fucking with you. You ain't the nigga online screaming at me, bro. Him, oh, and good morning. He's still going. Shut the fuck up, man. Nobody fucking with you, bro. Chill out. See how black people don't know how to stop and keep putting themselves in the middle of shit? I'm not fucking with you, bro. This live is about all the naysayers and the one-time members that didn't have a hit record, by the way. I had like the one record that I play all the time, A Quiet Taste. That's it. The rest of that shit was okay, nigga. You're not LL Cool J, nigga. All right? All that, huh? I'm gonna drip ice cream down my chest and run down to my genitals. All that, get the fuck out of here with that bullshit you was spitting, nigga. Get on some real game time, nigga. Get out of here, nigga. You know what I mean? Oh, my bad, Shy. You took somebody else, Shy. My apologies. Some said that three-headed told me that. Boom. I thought he was still trying to defend it. I'm not fucking with you, Shy. Say about you, Shy. Anyway, but my thing is, was me not kicking War Brim really internet worthy? Was it really worthy for Stats to take to the internet disrespecting me? You know what I mean? Was it really that necessary? Because he wanted me to kick Wall Brim out, and I was waiting for them to tell me they wanted to have a vote. You can't kick a member out without a vote. And in that vote, you have to show where this nigga did some foul shit to make us kick him out of the group. And I stood by that. It could be U300. It could be David Soto. It could be Eric Kumba. It could be any of y'all. Do y'all want CK to throw y'all out and give y'all a fair shake and have a team meeting? And after that team meeting, we vote on whether or not you should stay or go. Is that not the right format in which I should do shit? That's all I want to know. That's it. You know what I mean? You understand? Let's be real. I don't know all that shit, but I don't care what niggas put up, man. I keep telling niggas, nigga, I'm across the bridge. Where are we meeting at? Because I know that energy is going to change. Why? Niggas know I'm a bulldog. Niggas know how I give it up. So all that screaming, yelling, and all this and that at the top of your lung, I'm a motherfucking bulldog. And niggas know that shit, nigga. And I do bite. You know what I mean? Bottom line, man. But back to what I was talking about. You know what I mean? Now, that's not what it is, bro. I like having people hear me out. You know why? It's going to be some real shit I'm about to say, homie. You know I like to be heard out, bro? Because the same way one of my homies can run down and splash one of you niggas, I can get splashed too. It can happen to anybody, bro. Because people allow themselves to go misunderstood. That's why. See, them dude, I don't give a fuck. Fuck it, it is what it is. It is what it is. And when a nigga put fire on their ass, yo, some went too far. How he go too far? And you just told him it is what it is. I'm a real nigga. I watched a whole lot of bad men get took the fuck down, get gunned down, get beat the fuck up. You know why? They didn't understand that one principle. It can happen to anybody. Every dog has his day. You feel me? Every dog has his day. You know what I mean? Every dog has his fucking day, bro. And you know why? A lot of motherfuckers really don't believe it can happen to them. A lot of niggas really get online and think they motherfucking Superman or Gunga Din or Iron Man somebody. I don't know. Y'all know I talk my talk, nigga. I talk that fly shit, though. I talk that get money shit. I had these conversations because dude forced my hand. Time and time again, I had these conversations. Up until somebody get mad at me, or y'all ask me the questions you're asking me right now? Nah. Yo, CK, how do I get my OSHA card? Yo, CK, yo, so if I'm doing X, Y, Z, this and that, blah, blah, boom. Yeah, blah, blah, boom. We talk about money. We talk about growth and development. We talk about having a clean shirt, baby. Popcorn, suck my dick. You know what I mean? Boom. You know what I mean? I see you saying lie, homie. I ain't paying you no mind, bro. You don't know me, man. You couldn't step a day in my shoes, homie. Trust me, you could, not because you're gonna get corned, because my shoe's too big, homie. You be running around flip, like you got fucking chiclectas on your feet, nigga. My shoe's too big, nigga, for the average nigga. Ask y'all 120 that. Ask them how much shit I got my hands in. Ask Nitros and anybody else that. Should you ask Jack Frost, anybody? Oh no, I got my hand in mad shit, bro. So I can be in a position to help the team. You dig? But if follow me, keep giving niggas handouts, that ain't happening no more, bro. And that's the reason why you see niggas showing their face now. And I ain't mind giving that little buck here, the $40 here, $50 here. It was okay. $200-$300 here, it was okay. I was America's favorite tough guy because I broke bread. Soon as I started saying no, oh, I'm a bad guy now. Now I'm not valid no more. Depending on the song, bro. If the song is hot, I do it for free. You know what I mean? If a nigga asks me to get on some wax, then yeah, I gotta charge you, bro. You know what I mean? If it's a hot joint, I hop right on that bitch. You know? But yeah, so at the end of the day, now this is what people don't understand, right? All right, Keiko, I see you. This is what people understand, right? Now that this dude went astray, right? I got to turn around and spend more money, $65 per record, to take all his verses off of the hybrid music now. Except for his song that he sung, which is only a few. He ain't said a bunch of songs of his own creation. That's just delete. I just delete that. But I gotta unwrap a whole lot of music. But I think Nigel gonna keep him on his songs, which I'm cool with that. Like I said, I don't have a problem. I don't have a problem with that, man. They got a problem with me. You know what I'm saying? I just said, call you, what bro? All right, I got you. You know what I'm saying? So once again, that's more money being spent now. Cause now I gotta take him off of all these songs, put Ratchet Rigo, Sean trapping him in his place. Yeah, Shooter Low stepping back up, put Shooter back in his place. With all that music now. You know what I mean? Like, come on. And for what? Is it really worth all that? Because I wouldn't throw a nigga. You know what I mean? Yeah, good looking, bro. Thanks for the compliment. Because I wouldn't throw a nigga out of Eastern District. So you let this outside nigga get in your head and turn you against your fam. It's no wonder why you feel like you a lone wolf out here in these streets. You know what I mean? There's no wonder. There's no wonder, bro. Maybe you should stop playing victim and playing, you know, abused or the innocent and look at your actions, bro. Maybe it's a reason why people ain't really fucking with you and your family. Maybe it's your disposition. My niece is like that. Yeah, talking shit and all type of shit. You live under her roof. She paying your bills. You ain't got a job. I mean, she's still giving you money to buy you fucking underwear and clothes and bras and shit, little mama. You an ungrateful little motherfucker. But you think somebody is blowing yours. You think, excuse me, somebody's in your space. How is somebody in your space and it's they fucking house? You know what I'm saying? It's they house, how they in your space? You know what I mean? You don't have a job? Wherever you in, I can help you get a job, bro. Right? At the end of the day or whatever, my thing is, I'm pulled the valet wall brim in his space. It was that space too. So that argument was they argument. Yeah, Lamonte was a motherfucking a member. He was a member. But he wasn't that member. This why when Stats took off on Warbrim, I mind my business. I let them have their fallout. So I can't throw Stats out of his space, nor could I throw Warbrim. When Lamonte got fly, I threw him out the space. I did that. Then Stats, getting crazy, and eventually I threw him out the space. Why? Homie, I ain't nobody's bitch, homie. You know what I'm saying? I ain't nobody's bitch. And when I start coming in my room and I can't use my shit, I get a fucking green dot put on my shit and I still have no control in my room, now we have a problem. So yeah, I kick niggas out. After the fact, not before. Not before. You know what I mean? Not before. You know what I'm saying? So with that said, I'm gonna tell you what we not gonna do. We not gonna keep taking to the internet lying, man. That's for everybody. Stash 280, Lamonte Sims, Popcorn, suck my dick. And all the rest of you niggas. All right? We not doing that. All right? If you have a problem with a man, at least have some type of fucking merit. Popcorn, suck my dick. At least have some type of honor about what you do. You know what I mean? Do that. You know what I mean? Do that. Divine, suck my dick. Nigga. That's how I'm giving it up, nigga. I ain't fuck with none of you niggas. 2022, nigga. Get off the internet. Call my phone, nigga. Any of you niggas want a problem with the motherfucking dog, holler at me, nigga. And my DMX boys, you know. Holler at the boy, man. Stop playing, man. All right? All this extra online shit, looking for attention, my nigga. That's out the window, my nigga. Maybe this is the last video I have to do to defend myself. Live stats, I know you watching. We'll deal with that later on. You calling the wrong phone. You want to talk, call it for. You want to scream and yell, don't call it. I'm hanging up. You can talk like a fucking grown man, though. At the end of the day, you want to get in? I know this dude, too. You know what I mean? So my thing is, if y'all going to do something, do it the right way, man. Get off the internet with this corny-ass girl shit, screaming, lying on a nigga. Bottom line, man. You know what I mean? Hey, come on, young man. Come on back there, Pop. Like, stop that shit, man. Stop coming at a nigga koofy. You know what I mean? Because a never nigga told you you should come at a nigga koofy, man. Come at a nigga koofy with facts. You know what I mean? Bottom line. And if Shot did tell you that I lied stats, then you being less than a man by not exposing this bullshit. The same way I got you on the phone, no backbiting, get it done the right way. Bottom line. Yo.
Yo, you have a blessed day, bro, man.
You ain't answer the question though. Did you tell Stats I lied?
What happened?
Did you tell Stats I lied?
Did I tell Stats a lie?
That I lied.
That ain't the narrative you pushed to me. You said that I told him that.
I sent you the message, bro.
You
we ain't gonna argue. Go on your phone and look, but I don't wanna argue with you.
It ain't no argument.
So that's what I'm saying. Go in your phone and look at it. Look at no. Listen, forget what I said. Read the message that came with that man. I'm gonna let you talk. But listen, don't argue with me. Read the message that was sent to me and I forwarded it to you. That's all I'm telling you. I ain't making it up. Read it. I sent it to your phone.
I don't listen to messages and all that, bro. You know that, man.
Like, I sent you a text message to your phone,
niggas,
bro.
If I was to listen to niggas, I'd have been went against you or did some foul shit.
All right, just read the message, please.
I never went against you. I never said nothing bad about you. The narrative I got was you said that you were calling a snake when you had Warren's phone. That was the narrative I got.
That ain't what I did, bro, because I ain't had nothing to do with that. I called your phone. Stop, Sha. We're not going to even do that, bro. It's on blood. It's on GKB now. I'm back. It's back. I got to pull that card. This is gonna hurt, nigga. I called your phone. Bottom line. I said, well, stop right there, Wall. Get Shaw on the phone. Did I not do that? You see how long it takes to answer? How you can't answer a fact?
Yo, so you know ahead of time, somebody just called me. You know who's on the phone. That.
He can say what he wants. Just talking bad.
No, stop. Let me get the floor first. And. I'm gonna let y'all rock out. I hope, you know, I told Stats already what it is. Like, y'all gotta be easy. Like, but check it out, man. I don't know how you got that false narrative. Stats never said that tonight,
Troy.
I was on the phone. That's what I'm saying.
That's all right,
Bashad,
I sent you the text,
stop,
bro.
Stop.
What part of I sent the text? Is this motherfucker not listening to?
Bro, I don't care what Nike said. I was on the phone.
Yeah, I hear you, Stats, but hold on, Stats. I'm gonna try to show him that I'm not making it up. I sent the text message, bro.
No, but regardless of what, he was on the phone. He saw action. That's why you're painting a different narrative than what exactly happened. And that's the problem. You sit here trying to defend yourself so much that you don't realize that you're actually carrying yourself. Bro, you can't.
Hey, yo, Stats, I'm a fucking murderer, my nigga. Just so you know that. I can't bury myself. I bury niggas, homie.
I don't want to hear.
I understand that, nigga.
Other shit. Bro, you just sat here and lied and said that I don't have a job. I live with my family. Nigga, I don't know.
Who said that?
Bro, you don't even know me like that.
Who said that?
You don't even know
hey, yo,
like
who
that,
said
bro?
You don't have a job?
You just sat there and said that in this live, bro.
All right, guess what? I bet you, listen, my nigga, I bet you. Let me switch in my pocket. Look, y'all, look. Look, y'all. Look. This is on my. Look, this is on my flag. Look, see this man?
Look,
on my flag. If you find why I say he don't have a job, I get this nigga all this bread right here. No, I'm showing the camera. Look, he can have all this bread right here. This is 5 bands on my flag. If I say he don't have a job, Stats don't have a job, he can have all this bread right here.
Bro, who you talking about? Who you talking about?
I never said you don't have a job, bro.
Listen. Respectfully.
Listen.
Let's get back to the point, because that's neither here nor there. Because regardless if you said it, I don't care because it's not a fact.
Shy texted you. He didn't say that. Shy in the middle of this shit, bro.
Okay, so whatever. Let's get back to why.
Look, why you doing that shit, Stats? Shy got a fight when I get down, so I hope you know that, so. Why you doing that? You making it work for Shy.
I fight Shy back. It don't matter.
You can't fight Shot Battle. You ain't blood, homie.
So if you feel comfortable in that attic, and I was just there.
You got the attic.
No,
you wasn't.
The whole bunch of the
H-rays. No, you wasn't.
Stop playing with me. They don't even know shooting low like that. They don't even know shooting low like that. So good luck on pushing the weak-ass nigga. But at the end of the day, let me tell you something about me, bro. I'm not the type to pick no side. I pick the truth. Warren was in wrong. He was in violation. He looked bad. By basically going up there trying to push a different narrative when it was me and Lamonte basically pushing a positive narrative. He wanted to push a destructive narrative of telling us, oh, what you mean? Oh, we should be able to talk about the East and the West. That's what Rack was pushing. So I had to go back and reconstruct the actual argument. Now, as he was on the phone talking about another homie that was a part of our shit, and he kicking his back in to a nigga who was alleged op of ours?
That's
how the hell
are
you telling
over.
Us that
That's
we got to take over. A vote to get him out the fucking Eastern District?
And I agree
Number
with
one,
you.
I'm the reason the Eastern District lit, nigga. How many times
no,
we
you're
went
not.
Viral, nigga?
Stats, no you're not, Stats. Stats, no you're not, Stats. Stats. That shit was big before you got there, bro.
I put more work in than you ever did, nigga. I made your shit lit, nigga. Remember that time?
Shaw, you agree with that?
Bro, remember that
Shaw, you agree with that, Shaw?
Look up the rec room. Look up the rec room. Remember when you went on YouTube, bro? I was pushing your channel.
And you had 300 views, Stats.
Bro, y'all begged me to basically take a position in the Eastern District. I didn't even want it. Then when I get to doing my thing, you start to basically pulling me back. Oh, no, don't argue with Wack 100. But, nigga, you started it.
I never said that. I never said that. That's a lie, Stats.
Nigga, soon as you had a conversation.
That's a lie, Stats. You know it.
That's
Stats. That is a lie, Stats. You know it. You know that's a lie, Stats. What I said, word for word. What I said, listen to me, look. What I said, word for word, was, I said, yo, if a nigga shoot at hybrid, you fire back, but don't turn into an all-week thing.
No, but listen, let me tell you something, Corey. See, this is the main reason why I stopped fucking with you. Because me, I'm a Keyway. You a Damu. I never looked at myself as a Keyway dealing with you. I looked at myself as hybrid. But every time I fight your battles, you don't look at it like hybrid. Look at it as Keyway and Damu.
No, I don't. Now you lying on me. Hey, yo, time out. Hold up. Stats.
So,
look, I chose Bossy over him. But meanwhile, Bossy making videos that I chose you over him.
The reason I'm mad on your channel is because you didn't want me to do my thing.
That's a lie. Hey, listen, first of all, the whole fucking world. Listen, the whole. Hold up, Stats, listen. I heard you, but hear me out. Hear me out there. Listen, you said that. Listen.
You were there.
You was involved. You know what, Sean? Answer that for him, Sean. Answer that for him now.
What's the question?
He said that.
If the whole beef between Oso Bossley and myself, did he not take a stance to say that he owes the loyalty to Oso Bossley? So that way he told me that I could.
I want to see how long it takes Sean to answer this one.
Dang it, going against Oso Bossley. Honest to God, I'm going to keep it tall. I don't remember that conversation, but I know that niggas didn't go hard like we was going hard. Like, let's keep it real. If you want to keep it real, yeah, every time that we went hard on niggas, like, it was always some fallback shit.
Hold up, Sean revealing his hand. She listen. No, Stats talk. No, Stats. Let Sean talk. Go ahead, Sean. Go ahead. We listen to you, silent partner.
Like
you just left your fingerprint, baby.
Like I said, every online beat that any one of us ever had, it started from you. Like, honestly, nobody knew that. Hold up. Nobody knew Stats like that. When I say knew him like that, his name wasn't out there. My name was out there, but it wasn't out there like that. For that, everybody was trying to come at you.
Everybody eyeballing himself.
Oh, God.
He killing himself right now.
From every nigga that we had a kid down, like.
Also, Bossley like, and Stats was beefing because of. Time out. Time out. Shout.
Hold up, Shout.
Nah, listen. Time out. Shout. Hold up, Shout. Hold up, Shout.
I didn't know how so Bossley was forgiven for doing 13.
Look, listen, he wasn't forgiven. Look, that's what the problem is, though, Sean. Hold up, Sean. Hey, yo, Sean, shut the fuck up, but I'm talking, man.
He's mad.
Nah. I want to say something. Look, everybody, look. Listen, that's 280 Oso Bossy beef was because of them dumbass niggas hanging in Jersey.
It started over you, nigga.
Hey, yo, on my flag, Sean, it started because they was together in the fucking studio. In the studio, they went over there. Hold up, look. Hey, yo, Sean 120. Sean.
Hey, Sean, my thing is this. How you so tough with us, but you ain't tough with your opposition? You don't know what I do.
You made me not question myself, because my loyalty is always to you. I know. I said that on the way out the clubhouse.
I said that on the way out the clubhouse.
I know.
My loyalty is always to you. I'm never
going
to
change your name. You can turn it to twerking when you explain yourself.
Yo, Corey's a homo. Corey did this. Corey, nah, that's bullshit. Now, do Corey do bullshit?
Backroom conversations, y'all. Look, do Corey do bullshit?
Yes, I can agree with that. But do Corey do that bullshit?
Hey, yo, let me talk, though. Hey, Sean, let me say something. Don't say shit. Let me refresh your memory now.
Hey, bro, and I don't appreciate you went up here slandering Sean's name. And Sean only told the truth. You got people in talking about he dishonorable and all this.
Because he is. Let me talk. I get it. Hey, yo, Sean.
I know where my loyalty lies.
I'm about to send bullshit to his doorway because he keep talking.
Hey, yo, Sean.
Let me say something. Hold on. Listen, let me talk. First of all, Also, Bossy was gambling, and according to the stats, niggas played him. That's how they beef started. Had nothing to do with CK.
Yo, bro,
I wasn't hanging with the niggas.
Hold up, bro. You giving information. You giving information for that nigga to say about me. You went and repeated that shit.
Everybody said too much. Look, facts. Look, see facts? Look.
Yeah, hey, bro, it ain't no loyalty between me and you. It was just loyalty to your business. That's how you wanted me to be.
Look,
but I'm on some real life street shit, bro.
See what he said? Look.
You sat there and utilized.
He said, I be on blood time, but the reason why Boss was mad, I wouldn't go against
that. I would have left that nigga as an example if it wasn't for you, nigga. So what are you talking about?
Guess what, bro?
You
said, did I ever tell you stop? No, answer the question, Stats. Did I tell you stop? Stats.
Stats. Stats.
A teddy bear coat. Look, he said, teddy bear coat. Look, hate. It's hate. It's hate. Face it, nigga. You ride my dick, nigga. You like, you love my swag. You just hate it, though.
Who you talking to?
Yeah, I'm talking to you. I'm talking to you. You ride
bro,
my dick.
Every tooth out your mouth, my nigga.
You ain't doing
like,
yet.
Stop playing with me, bro. Like, seriously, bro. Stop playing with me.
Hey, yo, Shell 120. Shell 120. This is what's
up. Look.
You know why, son? I don't internet beef, bro. And guess what, bro? And guess what, bro? He apologized every chance he gets to, though.
Hey, bro. And then, hey, listen. And then the same nigga who just tried to push. That same nigga always
hit
why he ain't doing the hit.
Did I do it?
What the fuck is you talking about?
Did
ain't
I do it? Did I
and
do
I'm
it? Did I say the poor child? Hey, Stats. Stats. Look, Stats. Stats. Is that about
get
you, Stats?
Stats. Home,
I get it, but guess
stop
what, Stats?
Me, nigga. Look. Disrespect me,
look.
Bitch.
Look. Look,
yo,
look,
lying
look,
shit.
I hear you, man.
Nigga, you
whatever,
might be
nigga.
Gay, nigga.
I know.
Devon says you gay, nigga.
I know.
I don't know that nigga.
I know. I got more business than you ever had in your life. Shorty?
Bro, you might have had more trannies than me,
yeah.
But other than that, I don't
I
deal
know.
With women, bro.
Yeah, very cute.
I don't know what you talking
very
about.
Very cute. Very
talking
cute.
Some weirdo shit, nigga.
Very cute, bro.
Trying to turn some gay shit.
Look.
Nigga, tell that shit
look,
to Devon, pussy.
Look.
Go argue with Devon, pussy.
Hey, yo, Stats, look. Look, look. Look, listen.
Damn,
we can't hit him no more. Listen, y'all. Look what I do. Nah, ain't no here we go. Look what I did, bro. Because I'm such of a monster. I played checkers, not even chess, to show the whole world how Shaw 120 been having backroom conversations about me. Now, don't tell Stassi Wilder. Stassi's doing what an op do. He's been an inside op. He's a plant. He's been a plant. Now, I mean, no. Evan Coleman, we don't stop it. Now, I mean, look what he said, look. See that? Shaw 120 only good because of CK. The whole world know I carried you, nigga. And then if you did that, you so dumb. This is why I say, stop. And all those years of me doing that, it went over your head, nigga. I just played you. I knew you was going to get a phone with Stats and talk to him. And guess what? I pulled you out, my man. I pulled you out.
Hello.
I pulled you out, Sean. Do your man Stats. I won again. You can't beat me. Stupid nigga. Now you fool. Top of the game.
Yo, top of the game, man. Big SL, man.
Hey, beloved, did you see how I played, Shaw? I knew he was going to get on the phone behind the scene and talk to his man, and he just couldn't stop. And this is the reason why I keep telling him, bro, you're not equipped to play on the level that I play on, bro. Okay, cool. I'm going to say certain shit. They texting each other, talking. They on the phone. And guess what happened, bro? I once again, CK winning, get him smarter than you niggas, bro. I ain't even mad at Stats. It's the snake, the perpetrator. Shaw 120.
He said, "Hey, yo, big bro, salute, man.
Yeah, salute.
Yo, this wavy to Herc, your brother, my nigga.
Salute,
you already
beloved.
Know what it is." Yo, man, listen. I remember when they started that rhetoric. Them niggas done blocked me out the rooms and clubhouse. And
yeah.
Nigga stacks to where your bitch, my nigga. I violated the nigga yesterday, CK, and everyone could tell you, Shaw 120. He even tried to get Shaw to holler at me and Shaw in the FaceTime and each other and all that because I had to go at Shaw's head. Yo, my nigga, don't ever question Don Moose for no fucking hardback pussy nigga that befriended the homies on YouTube.
Thank you. Sought
them out.
Facts.
Got their phone numbers. Went through their states to hang out with these brothers. And now, because you want to dick ride and try to take and make a little platform, nigga, You want to try to slander my homie's name? That shit would never go down with the Icy's, my nigga, because I'm on deck. I gave that nigga stacks my address, DK. Told that nigga pull up to the third, to the pound.
Yeah.
He ain't been there yet. That nigga pussy, my nigga. I want all that smoke with you, nigga. I'll handle you, nigga. You want to eat Ricket, nigga.
The nigga said, shout out to 2021 because he need
nigga.
Things.
DK too busy getting money, my nigga, to handle you. You a worm, nigga. Stop playing with the fucking homies, my nigga, because niggas will really hurt you, Stack.
Look.
You could duck me on Clubhouse, my nigga. I'm going to pull up wherever you at, my nigga.
Hey, you heard me, listen. Nigga. Look, everybody know, look. Everybody said, look. They said Corey got both of you lit, but wasn't enough. I guess them be trying to help niggas. Niggas know what time it is, bro. Shot 120 crossed me being jealous of Nitro, bro. When I got the situation with Nitro, Shot, you 55 years old, literally. Nobody want, look, say, look, everybody said, look, Shot show his head. Nigga, I am the best at what I do. I'm telling you what it is. Look, they said Shaw gotta make this super right. Not cool. Like I said, it's all because of you, Shaw 120. As I said before, I ain't mad at you, bro. Explain that to the homies in North Carolina, though. Oh, is that CK State? That's my state.
Hey, yo, CK, yo, big bro.
Perks always up, nigga. You can't beat me, nigga.
CK,
don't call my phone. You a dub, homie. You a dub. You a dub, Shaw. Don't call my phone. Don't call my phone, blood. You a dub, homie. You showed your hand. The whole world seen it. You keep fucking with the mastermind, and you know what I do. Yeah, my bad. I didn't cut you off, blood. Can't say what you were saying.
No, it's all good, Scrap. I just wanted to give you this last thing because I know you on your vibe.
Yeah.
2 days ago, I started my platform. It's called Push That Knife. You can check it on Clubhouse, my nigga. You know what I'm always shouting you out. Welcome to Shy One. Days, my nigga.
Facts.
You go on my YouTube. I went crazy on Whack yesterday. I got 80,000 views already on my shit, Scrap. That nigga had the nerve to go and make a page in that UP thing that he started to put. He's a clout chaser, man. He just loves everything the homies do, my nigga. He idolizes niggas like you and us.
Facts.
And he just don't know how to accept that. He's trying to ride our dick and our wave, and that shit ain't happening, my nigga. Stay in your lane, my nigga. You a hardback, my nigga. You go and get yourself hurt playing with the homies, my nigga.
Don't call, Shy. You're dumb, bro. You exposed your hand, and I know your girl probably saying, yo, why the fuck did you just do that? This is why CK keep telling you, Shy, shut the fuck up sometime, bro. Because you wanted to play games? I said, yo, before I even came out the house, I said, yo, this is the day that I exposed Shy with that exposing him. I'm going to get it to popping on Stat's name, but really aiming at Shy, but keep telling Shy I'm not aiming at him to make him feel comfortable enough to hop out the window. Welcome to your retirement party, baby. You beat yourself,
yo,
nigga.
CK,
I don't gotta beat you, nigga. You beat yourself this, every time, nigga.
Keep look,
nigga said dumb station drop off point. You done, nigga. I'm not answering the phone, Shy. You did it to yourself. Explain it to Bootsy and everybody how you just clowned yourself, nigga. You done. We don't have nothing to talk about, homie.
Keep doing this thing,
hold that down.
It's
yeah.
Icy world, east side, my nigga.
All the time, beloved. All the time, nigga. Like shine like Robo,
you
nigga.
You always trying to show love and open and extend your arm even to those that are not like us. And this is what happens because there's some people that don't know how to handle friendship and sincerity, my dude. There's a lot of these clown niggas. They don't know nothing about honor. They're wasting
facts.
These clowns.
Exactly, bro. And that's and I'm starting with Shy with 20 fake ass. Yeah, you a snake, nigga. You a dick riding snake, nigga. You ride the dick of ops, nigga. You don't get no love and respect, nigga. And guess what? I already told Viking I was going to do this. You know what that mean? That didn't mean that E-Trubs and Viking was watching today, bro. You played yourself. So Far Rock know now. And I'm hearing, all right, King Cobra. It's too late, Sean. They heard you going in nonstop. Yeah, because you know, it's that. I had nothing to do with Oso, Bossy, and Stas Beef. They was gamming by themselves doing them. Stas didn't like what he seen. He said the dude was going to play Jazzo. He said to defend Jazzo. And guess what happens? He shot and said, I'm a bozo. You a bozo? Hold it down. I'm going to beat the fuck out of you when I get back to North Carolina. I'm going to stomp you out. All right? Just know that. Dead serious. Right in front of your baby mom. She's going to see you get your ass. So look. Look, see, listen up. Damn, shot going out like 80K. Look, I told you, nigga, see it now. You exposed your hand, bro. You's a goofy, nigga. Not me, you a goofy, nigga. Nigga, when you made a call in Virginia, nigga, and they was on your heels, who saved your life? You forgot about that? The same people you cool with in Virginia? Who made you cool with them, Sha? Don't you get it? The list goes on, Sha. You know what I mean? Not good, said Sha 120. Say goodbye to your wrench. He's out of here. In fact, somebody y'all, anyway, boot this nigga. He's not even good no more. He ain't good amongst us no more. We don't need snakes, you heard? Ow, my finger hurt. Pussy ass nigga. Top of the game. Hello, top of the game.
Yeah, what's popping, bro?
Don't call my phone now. You was, and you hate it. Everybody heard you. Yeah, because you don't. You can't double team me, nigga. I beat you niggas already. I played a mind fuck, and both of your niggas are looking stupid right now. Don't call my phone, bro. Call Stats phone. That's where you belong at. Call Stats phone. Maybe you could join his gang. You done, nigga. You opt yourself. Don't call my phone no more, bro. You opt yourself. Hey, yo, my nigga. I'm not letting Sha speak. This wasn't for your entertainment. This was for me to give him an opportunity to do right or do wrong. He did bad. He got to live with it now. Shout out to D-Town to Detroit. He got to live with that now. How do you erase this? Because this is going to stay up. Look at Boosie. See, Boosie texting now. Look, see, Boosie texting because they watching it, bro. You played yourself. These niggas watched you, bro. He's in trouble now. He played himself. How do you do that? How do you not be smart enough? And I told your brother, Dah, that I was going to do this. Yo, Dah, I'm going to play with him, but not really fuck with him and fuck with the next nigga. And through the next nigga, we going to find out if I'm wrong about Sha having a conversation about me or not. You prove me right. Whoa.
Hey. Whoa. I got 6 phones. What, you ain't gonna let me speak?
Nah, nigga, you done. I mean, I did it with Bootsy calling. You done, nigga. We don't wanna talk to you, nigga. You did enough, bro. You did enough. We don't wanna talk to you no more. You know what I mean? You did enough already, man. You need to unwrap that. The nigga, the whole time, I ain't talking about you, Corey. Just now, I kept fucking with Stats. Cause I know Stats gonna respond. He gonna say something. Like, yeah, Sha, you Then, when Stats came on, you know what I mean? Sha lost it. Yeah, cause every time it happened, we went to war for you. Nigga, I've been on this motherfucking earth 51 years, my nigga. And walked comfortable in my skin. Put mad working for myself, nigga. I've been saving your ass from day one. I can't say that about Stats. But you, Sha? You know how many times you been fooled? Let's be real, you been fooled and I stopped it. How many times? So you know I'm sending this rate to sis, ASAP. This video getting rate to sis phone, bing. So we see that shit? They don't go, wow. See, it says keep it impartial. I was keeping it impartial. I ain't go against Stats. I ain't go against Ward Brim. I am a grown ass man living a real life. I don't have a virtual life. I have a real life. Real affairs, real bills, real kids. So when y'all doing it on that internet shit, you know what I mean? Look, nigga said Sha 120 on 5 Love. And the whole world heard you, bro. Everybody like, yo, Sha, what the fuck is wrong with Sha? Yo, said, nah, Sha say it ain't so. You said it yourself. Now, I ain't gonna lie, on mad occasions, yo, we trying to figure out, you know what I mean? Come on. You bugging out, my nigga. I just played a mind fucking. You fell right into it, my nigga. You fell right into it. Look, see what homie said? The people want to hear Sha 120 dig his grave. Come on, call up, Sha. They want to hear you. Call up. Call up, Sha. I got to put gas in the car and shit. Call up, Sha. Call up, Sha. Come on. Come on, Sha. Call up. I'm going to let you talk, Sha. Come on. Your grave already dug, though. You did it to yourself already. You can't blame me or fault nobody for what you just did. You just did that. Let this little corny nigga pull you out of pocket. I just say, yo, shout 30 times. Stop. Be quiet. I'm not coming at you just because I was coming at you. I wanted you to hop out the window and call stats, which you did. Then you began to get online and argue with me with him and try to help get at me. You can't get at me, nigga. I'm the best that ever did this shit. Again, I'm listening. I ain't gonna say a word.
Yeah, I'm saying, yo, what's up, bro? I never said nothing disrespectful when he was just on the phone. I never said nothing disrespectful. I said the truth. What I said wrong? What I said wrong? Name one thing that I did wrong, bro. And why you keep trying to slander my name, man? Why? What I did to you, bro? What, I put war skirt up? That's what happened? I was wrong for that? Are you serious? I pulled the loud snake nigga around us, right? And I told him I would pull up. You was on the phone. And keep it real, man. Why you slandering my name like that? Me and Stats trying to jump you. He tried to get me to agree with something that I never heard. And I said I didn't hear you, none of that. Like, I mean, what do you want me to do? I never been a yes or man, man. Yes or man? I never been a yes or man, man.
Shout, let me tell you something, Shout.
You talking about Trump? I just got off the phone with Trump. Why would you use my brother, man?
Shout, let me tell you something.
You know what you talk about.
Let me tell you something.
See, Trump said you don't know what you talk about. But I don't even know why I did that. Why I bothered him like that. You know, we trying to get dad home. We know that ain't going to happen, but we trying to get him home, sir. Like, you know, I love you, my brother. Like I said when I ended the phone before, you're bugging out, man.
All right, that's what I didn't want to happen. Fucking car turned on. Hold on. They can't hear you, Sha.
For real. I don't understand that. Why are you bugging me out?
Listen.
That shit got my mom.
Listen.
What did I do?
Once again, word for what I said.
You're not my son, God, father?
Is that it? Look, peep game, man.
Don't let it be something that small.
Look, peep game.
Please don't let it be nothing that small because you're not my son, God, father.
Peep game, bro. Like I said,
shut the fuck up, nigga.
Look, he don't let me say this. I'm just saying, I'm not an internet. I can't beat you with screaming and yelling on the mic, but I fuck a nigga life up, and you know that. What I said, word for word, so don't get twisted. I talked the Viking, and so by now, E. Trump's everybody know what he did. Do I gotta say it again? I spoke to Viking, and I'm sure he told E. Trump. I can call Viking right now. He know what's going on. All right? Now, you gonna let me talk, or you gonna keep talking?
Yeah, talk, bro, talk.
Cause you put a word in my mouth, I didn't say that. I said I talked to Viking, so by now, E. Trump's everybody know what's going on, bro. You're going against the grain with me for a cornball-ass nigga who online lying, and you know he lying. When the fuck did Stats Beef and Jazzy have something
what
to do with me?
What did I agree with? That's what I'm
let
trying
me talk,
to tickle. Son, what did I agree
I'm
with?
I'm going
to
tell you right
that
now.
You saying I'm okay in something,
look,
bro.
Could you let me talk? You want me to talk, please?
Go ahead, bro.
When you said, could you guys, I always tell you, listen before you speak. Oh, well, yeah, because every time we got into the beef, it was over you and this and that, and because Stats were defending you and And it's true to the matter, bro, Nitro will tell you. That shit had nothing to do with me, Sha. Him and fucking Jazza was hanging out. He felt like Jazza going to play to his hood. You know what I mean? He went and exposed Jazza on the internet. CK's with you in the studio, nigga. That's why I kept saying, yo, Sha, no, it didn't. We was in the studio, they was hanging out, and you're not listening, so you co-signed what he said. Everybody in the chat like, nah, so it can't be. They can't believe what you was just doing, bro. You went on a tirade.
Mostly every beef we've got into has been over you. Nobody never shamed my name. Nobody said.
All right, but listen, can I say something, Queen, though?
They ain't talking about Corey James. Don't know me, Corey. Only you know me.
Listen,
only Stone D know me.
Listen.
Only Quell know me.
Let me talk now, Sha.
Only that really
Sha, let me ask you, Sha, but listen. See, there you go again. You're not listening. Did I need you niggas to save me, nigga, from an online internet nigga? From Wildcat on the internet? And they really gonna pull up on me, nigga? Let's be real now. On Herc. Do I need a nigga to help me? or hurt, nigga.
Nah, it ain't the point that you need a nigga to help you, but I'm not.
So if I didn't ask you, and I tell you I don't want you to do it, why the fuck y'all doing it? Nigga, you know what my case is about, nigga. The fuck are you talking about?
I just said why. Because I'm not gonna let nobody shame your name.
But Shy, you know I cannot handle if a nigga get hurt. You know what kind of list I'm on already, bro. The fuck? I gotta tell the world, nigga, I'm fighting for my freedom. I don't belong on the streets. I'm only home because I got lucky and they made a mistake. You know what the fuck my shit look like. The fuck you acting dumb for? Once again, you an elder. Tell a little younger than now, bro. CK can't handle no arrest. He get locked up for a felony. Bro, done for life. Career criminal. What happened to that child 120? What happened to that, Shy? You know my situation.
Nothing that they don't know, CK.
You
they,
need
they
to.
Shy,
listen to me, Shy. Listen to me, Shy. You need to. That's important, bro. If we do some shit online, we argue, and the internet nigga get
what's
hurt.
What's the matter?
And the internet nigga get hurt. Guess what happened now? CK going, that Shy 120. Not none of them. I'm going, you know why? I'm already in a fucking FBI watch list. All right, with that said, this fucking live is over. Man, niggas is dumb, bro. He know this shit, though.